Tonight's edition of Arizona Technology and Innovation looks at how ASU students are working with private industry and the military on a variety of innovative projects designed to address real-world issues. Here to talk about the program is Chell Roberts, Executive Dean of ASU's College of Innovation and Technology. Good to see you again. Thanks for joining
us. Very good to be here.
iProject's Innovation Showcase, what are we talking about?
Oh. We understand at the College of Technology Innovation that many students learn best when they're able to apply their knowledge in authentic context. What that means is that they take those lectures, they take the things that they read in books, and they do something real. You don't just read about designing a car, you actually go do it. You design the new product, the new innovation.
So this is now students teaming with industry to innovate on things that really do matter.
Really do matter. So we've created partnerships with a variety of industry, with government agencies, to take that authentic environment and to bring students and partner to solve their problems, to design new things for them, to create new enterprises.
Who decides on the students? Who decides on the partners?
Well, I go out and do a lot of that work, but there are many of us that work on finding new partners to work with us. That many of them are coming to us now. We've done this for the past 5 years. We started very small and we're getting very, very large with lots of industry and lots of partners coming to us.
Let's talk about some of these projects, because these sound fascinating, especially the one working with the Air Force on something called the Spider-Man Project.
Spider-Man's a great project. So imagine the things that Spider-Man can do. Spider-Man can climb walls. So what the Air Force came to us and said is, we'd like a student team to work on climbing walls while our soldiers have backpacks on them. And so our students created a mechanism for someone to go up a 10-story skyscraper right on the side. Kind of a suction device is what they created, so they can walk up the side of a building.
Like little geckos.
Like little geckos, yes. And it works.
With 100-pound backpacks.
Yeah, and it makes me scared a little bit to see students climbing the sides of walls. But yeah. Yes, they do it.
Yeah, they do. Okay. And this is viable. This is something that the Air Force, I guess, the military, can use.
They can. And so often what the companies and Air Force do is they have us do a first prototype. So we're creating the new idea and how it's going to work, and then they'll take it to a next generation of product. But yes, absolutely.
Honeywell, working with Honeywell on a fully automated touchscreen panel. What does that mean?
Very interesting. So Honeywell wants to test displays. They're looking at new cockpit displays. And you think about testing those displays, someone may have to touch a display 10,000 times to know how that display works. We don't want to hire a student or send an employee to touch 10,000 times a screen. So we created a machine for them that will do that testing. It's a robotic device that goes in and tests the screen by touching with different pressures, different angles, different drags, thousands of times for that testing.
And this is something Honeywell said we'd like to see develop?
Oh, yes. And now they're going to use it in their actual testing of the devices.
Okay. You bet. General Dynamics, this one I find fascinating as well, a self-sufficient shelter system.
Exactly. So one of the problems the military has is they'll get soldiers at a remote location, and then they've got to supply with water and energy those soldiers. A lot of injuries happen because of those convoys that end up going out. So what they wanted developed was more energy and more self-sustaining environment, so soldiers could go out, put up their tents, put up an environment, and get the energy, and be able to stay there without those convoys coming. So our students created one of these environments for them that will likely go into the next generation of their solution for these soldiers.
So a soldier can go to an isolated region, water, energy can be there for a sustained period of time instead of always having to go out there and come back or...
Exactly.
Wow. And it's working.
And it's working.
Wow.
Isn't that exciting?
Yeah, yes it is. Also exciting, in a much different way, is what's going on in Gilbert and dog poop.
Dog poop, exactly right. So at the Cosmos Dog Park, there are 300 piles of dog poop left a day in the park.
How much?
300 piles. And this is after citizens cleaning up some of the dog poop themselves.
Yeah.
So they came and said, what can we do about this dog poop? And we had an idea. So we put a student team with a faculty member together with the city. And what we created was a way to digest the dog poop and to create energy, gas, which now will light the lamps in the dog park. And that's going underground this week, where they're going to be able to use that.
More than one lamp?
So right now we have one lamp. We'll add multiple lamps as we go. Ours is the first prototype. But now we've been contacted by other cities, by New York, by Central Park, interested in doing the same thing inside of their parks.
So basically, you take the dog out there, he does his business, the business is converted into energy, it lights the park, so the dog has a better view himself doing his business.
I guess it's a self-sustaining system. Not only dogs, but everybody else.
Last one here is a solar-aided hot water system that SRP is developing, but you guys are teaming with SRP on this. How?
Well, SRP gives rebates for solar devices that people buy. And one of their questions is, well, how well do they really work? When we give a rebate, do we know that we're actually getting an improvement in energy efficiency, and how much? So what we did is we teamed to put in a number of solar devices and to spend a year testing those in different climates, different times of day, so that we could actually characterize for them how much efficiency is gained by the solar devices.
And again, viable, working?
Viable, working.
These are real industry changes. These are not academic exercises here. Give us an overview of iProjects and what students are getting from all these developments.
You bet. So as I told you earlier, we care about students learning in a different way. When students hear things, many students, when they hear things, they learn in one way, but then when they do things, they learn it much more deeply. So we created a whole environment around this with all these industry partners that come in. Now, industry partners benefit in many ways. They benefit because you have students now that you get to try out for a year. You get to see how well they do. They benefit because they get intellectual property and new devices. Our students benefit in a different way. Imagine the resume that a student has when they actually have done something, created a new device. They have something that's viable versus I have a degree and a grade.
And they have connections with some of the people that they're working with.
Often an entire team or 50% of a team to an entire team will be hired by the company.
Well, it sounds like a great deal, and congratulations and continued success on this, because this is very encouraging and it sounds like it's working.
And I forgot to mention, it just won the President's Innovation Award, so yes, it's working.
It is working.
And it's going to get bigger and better.
Good to have you here. Thanks for
joining
us.
Thank you so much.